Let's now step back and have a look at this parameters statement. Now, just by the simple fact that we have defined a brand new variable called myEE using the parameter statement is enough to tell the system we are going to generate our own selection screen. And the parameter statement is all we need to display a field on the screen. Let me just make sure this program works. And let's just display this one field on the screen. So there you can see we got my employee and we got an entry field. That's all it took, one statement. Now let's go through it in a bit more detail. As I said, it's very much like the data statement. We specify a new variable name. We can make it a type. So we could say type I for an integer. Or just like I've done here, I've used the like statement. So it picks up the field attributes of the employee field in our table zEmployees. Let's add a few more fields just as an example to show you how this works. So let's do my for date of birth. And we'll make this like, I think it's DOB is the field. Let's give it a check. And there you can see we've got a date of birth field. And it's picking up the parameters. And it's picking up the field attributes from the table. And it even gives us a drop-down box where we can select a date. How easy is that? Then if we want to do an example without using the like, we could say my number type I for integer. Oops, what have I done? Oh, just something I need to mention. When you specify parameters, you are limited to your parameter name being a maximum of 8 characters. And I think I just went over it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yep. So let's take off that E. There we go. My number. And one other point is the parameter statement can use any data type, just like the data statement, apart from floating point numbers. The floating point data type cannot be used as a parameter. You will have noticed when we showed the fields on the screen that the screen automatically gives us a text label here for each field. And it just uses our parameter variable name by default. And the order in which the fields are displayed are determined by how they are defined in our program. And one other thing to see is notice how our variable names are being converted to uppercase. This is the default action. So let's step back and clear some of these example parameters out. So we're back just to our employee number. And let's take a look at some of the additions we can use with the parameter statement. The first one is the default addition. So we could write default. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And no surprises, this is going to default this value into the field on the screen, as you can see here. Now, for those of you who are paying attention, the default statement actually isn't used with the data statement. For the data statement, we use the value addition, but for parameters, we use default. Now, the default is only a suggestion. The user can override the value. You know, there's nothing saying they have to use that. It's just a default value that we can populate on the screen to maybe cut down the amount of data we want the user to enter on the screen. Our next addition is by making the field mandatory. We can use the addition obligatory. So with this addition, we have the default, and we have the default value, and then we would just write obligatory. Let's just put these on a new line so it's easier to read. So you can see this addition here, when executed, forces this little tick box to appear in the blank field. So if I try to run the report, we get this message box at the bottom saying make an entry in all required fields. So we're telling the user you must put an entry in this field. It's a very useful addition. Now, another addition is the value check addition. But I just want to step back and let's have another example of a parameter. Now I need to jog my memory, so I'm going to open up a new session. Have a look at our table. Okay, for this, I'm going to use the ZEmployees2 table. And we're going to look at a field called gender. Let's make sure I've got everything correct. Now, with the gender field, notice when I click on it, we get the drop down. And this is because when we created this table, we actually created some individual values that can be used as a drop down list for entering data into that table. So when we use this field on a selection screen, the ABAP dictionary is working away in the background, helping to ensure any fields that we use like this automatically refer to any value help text or foreign key relationships that we've already set up to help the user to select valid values. Pretty cool, huh? So let's go back. And now here, I think if we try and run this program and put any old value in here, see, normally we would have to select M, F or U. Let's say I enter K. We don't get any error message or anything like that to say K is invalid. The only help we get is to say, hey, we've got some drop-down values for you. But this value check addition allows us to include value checking. So any entry we make into this field, the program will now check that entry against a valid value list that we have defined in the ABAP dictionary. Enter K, press enter, and there you can see, enter a valid value. M, press enter, everything is good. So that's the value check addition. And of course you could add it on if we had some values to check just at the end of this parameter as well. So we have three separate additions all in a row. So let's get rid of that for now and remove this entry for ZEmployees2. Okay, the last addition is going to be the lowercase addition. Remember I mentioned earlier that the parameter statement converts everything to uppercase? We can get around this by using the lowercase addition. So let's define a brand new parameter. And we'll be super original and use surname. We'll make it like Z employee surname field. And we're going to add a default value of Mr. Blogs, and then we're going to say lowercase. To demonstrate how this works and how it's taken effect, I'm going to enter some lowercase letters. And when I press the enter key, nothing happens. We still have the uppercase and we still have the lowercase letters in the field. If we didn't have the value check addition there, these lowercase letters would all be converted to uppercase. Let me show you that. So we'll take away that addition, activate our program, and now when I put a load of lowercase letters in and press enter, it converts them to uppercase. Let's pop that back in. And that's everything you really need to know about parameters. There are a lot more additions you can use, but really what we've gone through there is probably 99% of what you will see being used in SAP systems. If you do want to look at any of the other parameters, and this goes for any ABAP statement, just click on the field, press F1, and up pops the ABAP help to help you understand about all the different additions.